Hello and welcome everyone in this tutorial on Google Meet Chrome extensions. A lot of questions is there in your mind regarding how to take attendance in Google Meet or how to see all the participants all together using a grid view, and how can we apply visual effects or like blurring background, and how to use whiteboard during our Google Meet session. So here it is. I am here, Payal Bhattacharjee, for all of you to give a solution to all this. So let's begin. Let us start the browser first. So first of all, you open the browser. Let's open Google Chrome. Once you open it, before you start the Meet, you go for the Chrome Web Store. Search Chrome Web Store extensions. So once you are here, you will be able to download all the extensions. This is a kind of, you know, web market where we have come to buy the add-ons, the extensions for Chrome to download. These are all free and you can at any time you can download the extensions and you can enjoy them. So the first thing which we will do is we will download the Meet attendance. So click here in the search bar, you just click Meet attendance. So here it is. We will download, this is also Meet attendance, for taking Meet attendance. Let us go for this one, Google Meet attendance, and click Add to Chrome. And then click Add extension. So once you add the extension, you will be able to see the icon over here along with the address bar here in the browser. Yes, see here the icon has come. So let us go for another extension, and this time let us download the grid view fix. Meet grid view fix to see all the participants all together. This one, download the Google Meet grid view fix. This is the latest one which has come. Add to Chrome, it is checking. Click on add extension and you will be able to see the icon again for the grid. Yes, this has come. So grid meet grid view extension, where all the participants you can see at the same time in a grid. And the next one, Meet visual effects for blurring the background, so that only the focus of the camera is on you and not the background where you are sitting. So click on Add to Chrome and click Add extension, and again you will be see the icon over here, visual effects for Google Meet. You can blur the screen, you can get a green screen also, virtual green screen, you can inverse, you can do whatever you feel like. So this is the icon. And then again, let us search in the store, Google Meet Plus. This is for some added features like whiteboard extensions and emojis and inspirational quotes which you can enjoy. So add to Chrome, add the extension, and you will be able to see the icon again for Google Meet Plus. Finally, downloading the Mute All option from the Chrome Web Store, just click on that, and this one, Mute All on Meet. Add to Chrome, checking, add extension. So just wait, you will get that. Here it is. Mute All on Meet has been added to Chrome. So once you are ready with all the extensions downloaded, now you can go for the Google Meet session. Yes, so the Google Meet Plus is here. Now let us open another tab and let us start Meet meet.google.com. It is already come. Let us click on that, meet.google.com, and then you start a new meeting directly. So first of all, let me so I am starting. Start an instant meeting. Now see, getting started, new installation. Since you have added all the Chrome extensions, it will start giving you all the messages regarding the new installations and all. Click the blue question mark in the bottom right corner of this dialog to see the information again. Click next. Okay, you don't want all this thing right now. So plugins being installed, very good. And click on join now. See, one added pop-up dialog has come. A pop-up box is here, which will show you the participants, name of the participants, those who are attending the meet. So you can drag it and you can bring it here at the bottom also. Okay, now see, since your meeting has started, you are the only one right now, people only one. So to show you how you can take the attendance, what I will do is I will add one student meanwhile. Okay, now I have shared the code meeting, this one, NZGHDXABQW. This is the code meeting I have shared with one of my students, Agnishwar, and he is ready to join the meeting. So either you can deny entry or you can admit. Let me admit, or you can also deny. Oh, where is it? Yes, so admit the student. Okay, now two persons are there, and my grid view is on since I am able to see both my icon and as well as Agnishwar's icon, the student's icon. Now let us see how to take the attendance. See here, this pop-up dialog which is storing the details of the class list, two participants. Now how to save the file? Suppose there are numerous participants, suppose there are 30 participants in your class, then what you will do? Click on this, the list will be long over here, you will be able to see many names. Now click on this save button, save attendance, click here. So once you click here, your class list, see here at the bottom, your class list gets downloaded. So this one, now your class list has been downloaded, the CSV file, and now you will be able to see that. Now this, let's see the Excel file which we have just downloaded. See, the Excel file contains my name when I joined this, my arrival time, and the student's name with arrival time. So this is the arrival time, 17:12, that is 5:12 in the evening. So name and the arrival time you will be able to see, and the date also when you are taking the class here, 19 July. So in this way, you can take the attendance very easily, and every day you can get the attendance. So let us see what are the different other options we have. Grid view. And then what you have over here, this is the Google Meet Plus. Grid view by default, it is already taken as... by default it is already there. So now see this one, this is the Google Meet Plus extension, this one. Now here you have emojis which you can give while you are text chatting during Google Meet. You can use it in various other ways. You can share whatever you feel like, you can share a link, you can share image, you can share a link of a website. And then let us see the whiteboard part. So this is the whiteboard, this is the whiteboard icon. So let me minimize this, and It is showing that I have launched the whiteboard. Click here. From menu to join. Okay. So let me move this attendance part at the top, which I don't need right now. Now see, whatever you feel like, you can write over here. You choose the pencil, you write, you choose a color, you can choose a shape. Okay, now this is a pro feature actually. You have a only 3 days free trial with this whiteboard. So I'll talk about Google Jamboard in my next session, where we can use, and other whiteboards are also there, like Microsoft whiteboard. So I'm just crossing this right now. So let me show you now the visual effect. See here, you just take your mouse here, you will be able to see the visual effects which you can apply. Background blur, blur or bubbles. If you blur, then the entire screen will be blurred and your participants won't be able to see. See, it is not visible now. Now if you again deselect it, you will be visible. And if you want to blur only the background, see, the background gets blurred. See here, the background gets blurred, but the focus is on only the person, not on the background. What is the background? Again, if you click here, the background blur will be removed and the entire thing will be clear. Similarly, another effect is there, that is, see, I am removing the background blur. Now the background is visible, it's clearer now. And another one is bubbles. You can apply that, the bubbles will start coming out. So this much. So this was all about the Chrome extensions, how to take attendance, visual effects, and you can mute people. There is an option where you will be able to see how to mute everyone. This kind of a speaker option will be there, a microphone, where if you cross it, then all the participants will be muted at the same time. If you want, suppose you are a teacher and if you want to mute all the students all together at one point of time, then you can just click on that. So hope you have liked it, and keep watching all the videos. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Thank you for your patient hearing.